Now let's convert strings into integers. You might have a situation where you're importing some text and it is in a string format, but what you were actually interested in is the actual numerical value. And for that, we can use this parse function. So I'm going to get this computer variable called numb, and I put this text in it, and the semicolon just suppresses the output. Now let's take a look just to make sure that this is indeed an ASCII string. Now I'm going to create a new computer variable called val, and I'm going to parse as an integer this piece of string. Let's go for it. And now let's look at val. Indeed, it is 1001, which now looks a bit different, and indeed we can check the type of it, and it is now a 64-bit integer. So that's wonderful. We can import a bit of text and we can convert it into a number. Now let's go in the other direction. So we have this val underscore f, floating point value 1001.123. Let's run that. And just to make sure, it's a 64-bit float. And instead of parse, I now use string. And it's just this one type of string. So where we used the integer before just to say what we want to parse it to, here we just say the string function and we pass that argument. We're going to put this inside of a new computer variable called str underscore f. Let's just do that. Let's print it to the screen and you can see the quotation marks there. And just to make 100% sure, let's check the type. It is now an ASCII string. So we can go from string to numerical value and from a numerical value into a string. Sometimes we're going to import text and it is going to have a matrix like this, 3, 4, 5, 2, 1, 2, 3, 8, 1, 0, 2, 1. Now it is written like this because it might be so in the text file with the Julia notebook, because we've used the carriage return here to go to a new line. It's going to do this green color, which might make it look like a number, but it's all inside of these the quotation marks, so it's all just a string. Let me show you. There we go. You see the new line character there. So this is, we can well imagine we've just imported this from a text file. Now just make sure what this file underscore data is. Indeed, it's just a string. But imagine in your text file it was typed by someone to represent a matrix, a 3x4 matrix. Now I can read that in as an actual matrix. Let's have a look. I'm going to use this read DLM function. It takes this argument IO buffer, which takes an argument this string. I'm going to put this inside of a computer variable, which I've called data. So let's look see what data looks like. And indeed a 3x4 array of 64-bit floating numbers, two-dimensional. In other words, there's rows and columns. Just to make sure, it is now an array of 64-bit floating point elements, two-dimensional. So that's some common use scenarios where you've imported text and you want to convert it to values, or imported something that looks like a matrix and you want to convert it to a real matrix, or taking a number, going the other way and making a string out of it. In the next section of this lesson, we're going to look at finding and replacing characters and substrings inside of strings.